Charger Lab got an XDPS 2201 170W charger prototype from Infineon. It adopts a simple design of single-stage hybrid flatback topology for 24V to 36V lithium iron battery packs, and there's no PFC circuit. The synchronous rectification makes the system efficiency can be up to 95% under 230V AC when fully loaded. Due to the high efficiency, there's no need for heat sinks, as long as the gaps can meet the temperature requirements. Let's start to take a look at the module itself. The size is about 155 by 55 by 29 mm, and the weight is about 160 grams. The components are laid out sparsely. Here is the AC input end. As we can see, the input range is 198 to 264 volts, 50 or 6 tiers, and the DC output range is 18 to 42 volts. There is a black and a green connector at the output end. The small PCB of the auxiliary power supply is soldered on the side. And the power components are placed on the edge, making it easy to install external heatsinks. Starting from the input end, let's check all the components. The AC input wires can be installed in this connector. The specification of the input fuse is 2A, 250 volts. The varistor is used to absorb surge current. The safety X2 capacitor is from TDK, 1 microfarad. And the capacity of the other one is 0.68 microfarad. The common mode choke between the two capacitors is wound with magnetic core. The bridge rectifier is from onsemi, 8A, 800 volts. These three electrolytic capacitors for input filtering are from Rubicon, and they're connected in parallel, 56 microfarad, 400 volts for each. After that, we come to the primary side. The hybrid flyback controller is from Infineon, which is also the mass control chip. It integrates 600 volts high voltage startup cell for fast charging and can drive both high and low side MOSFETs. And the standby power consumption is less than 75 milliwatts. It simplifies the external components and adopts PG-DSO-14 package. These two MOSFETs are from Infineon P7 series and adopt TO220F package, 650 volts, 280 milliohm for each. The filter capacitor that powers the MOS control chip is from WE, 47 microfarad, 35 volts. The capacity of the resonant capacitor is 0.22 microfarad. The secondary side of the transformer is wound with insulated wires. Those two optocouplers are used to regulate voltage and shut down. Here is the orange Y capacitor. Next, let's look at the synchronous rectification circuit. The synchronous rectifier controller marked with IBUJN is from MPS and adopts TSOT23-6 package. It supports multiple modes and can drive the GaN rectifier. The frequency can reach 1 MHz. The synchronous rectifier is from Infineon and adopts Super S08 package, 150 volts, 60 milliohm. Then let's look at the output. One of the electrolytic capacitor for output filtering is from Chemet, 100 microfarad, 50 volts. These three 50 milliohm damping resistors are connected in parallel for output current detection. The low power operational amplifier is from Texas Instruments and supports a rail-to-rail input and output. It is used to control constant output voltage and current. The other electrolytic capacitor for output filtering is also from Rubicon, 50 volts, 680 microfarad. This SMD button is used to shut down. This black connector is used for current sampling. It can also set constant voltage and current and shut down. The green connector is used for output, and the upper wires can be inserted into it. Move to the small PCB we mentioned before. The digital mass control chip of the auxiliary power is from Infineon. It integrates a 700 volts MOSFET, and the standby power consumption is less than 100 milliwatts. These two electrolytic capacitors for input filtering are from Vert, 4.7 microfarad, 400 volts for each. Here is the blue Y capacitor. The optocoupler is used for output voltage feedback. This SMD solid capacitor for output filtering is also from Vert, 820 microfarad, 6.3 volts. Well, that's all components of this charger prototype from Infineon. It supports up to 170 watts output and can also charge lithium iron battery packs from 24 volts to 36 volts. Two mass control chips are from Infineon. Except for that, some components come from well-known brands such as onsemi, Rubicon, and Texas Instruments. Due to the hybrid flyback topology, it has a high efficiency. Compared with traditional electric bike chargers, there's no need for ventilation and cooling fans. So it can be assembled in a fully sealed case, just like a phone charger. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye!